We'll start the questions, and I'll begin, and it stays with you, Mr. MacIntyre. We don't have a bill before us on the strategic petroleum reserve, and I'd like to better understand the plans to refill. First of all, you might give us a little bit of a background on when we started the SPR. I think it was after the 74 oil embargo. A few of us are old enough to remember that. And how we determine and how we got to 700, almost 800 billion million barrels. Why did we think we needed 800? Where is the mark now? I think we're down around 400 now, or in that neighborhood. And where do you think we need to go? So if you give us a little bit, it might help the committee understand what we're trying to achieve. And I'm understanding also in the cavities that we use for this, you can't be taking oil out and putting it in at the same time. That's correct? Okay.
Yes, sir.
And also, if you can tell me if any of our cavities, we've had one collapse, as I'm understanding. We've lost one, correct?
No, sir.
We haven't? I thought we had. We had damage. For what reason? Yeah, we know we had damage to one, and we thought that was because of how we were managing it, but I could be wrong. Anyway, explain that, the shape that we're in. What is our total capacity to store oil, and where do you think we need to be? And give us a little bit of background, if you will.
Thank you, Senator, for the question. I wasn't old enough to be buying gasoline during the Arab oil embargo, but I was old enough to be in my dad's car while he was waiting in line.
While he was raising Cain and cussing, I remember those days.
So, yes, sir. So, as you said, the SPR was created as part of the Energy Production EPCA, Energy Conservation Act, and was created in 1978 as a result of the Arab oil embargo. It took several years for us to build up the reserves.
What did you have a target? What was it? Why did you set? How did you set a target of where you had to get? How much we had to have in the United States?
So initially, the target was set at 500 million barrels.
Gotcha.
It was then increased to a billion barrels. We eventually got to 715 million barrels of capacity. We reached that capacity in around 2013, 2014. We had about 700 million barrels at 2017 when we started the congressionally mandated sales. A number of laws have mandated us to sell over since 2017.
The sales, your evaluation of the sales that were mandated by Congress, was it to stabilize pricing or fill a void?
No, sir. It was for deficit reduction, providing funding for those bills. For
pay fors.
Absolutely.
We understand that.
Yes, sir. And right. There was.
We have a verbal over here. Awful.
Yes. So
on top of that.
So since we were at 700 million barrels, we sold a number of congressional mandated sales. We had 180 million barrels of emergency sales this year as a result of Putin's invasion of Ukraine. And so right now we are sitting at around 400 million barrels. Currently we have a study underway. It wasn't requested by Congress. It was something that we started on our own. It's under administration review that would look at various levels of the SPR and determine what kind of disruption that would mitigate against. In other words, if you consider the SPR as an insurance, what are you getting with the different
levels? Do we have legislative mandatory sales coming up?
Yes, sir.
Starting when?
So we've been doing it from 2017, and we've got them through 2031. We've got the key.
Does that fulfill the pay-fors that we?
That would fulfill the pay-fors, yes, sir. And
so we have to have that. So give me your plan. I think you have a little bit of an idea here.
Yes, sir. So we, as you said, we can't fill and release from the same site at the same time.
Gotcha.
It doesn't make sense for us to be releasing oil while we're trying to refill the SPR from the emergency sales. So we're trying to create an opportunity in FY24 through FY27 to stop those sales, either delay them to further out or cancel them, and then do a rescission on our account to make sure those pay-fors are accounted.
Selling the 180 million barrels, how much money do we have to spend to take off the...
So fortunately, yes, sir. Fortunately, we sold high. And so the average sales price for these emergency sales is about $96 a barrel. And the plan would be to purchase at roughly $70 a barrel or sometime around, somewhere around that. So we would have enough money to refill the 100.
And how much, what is our sales, $35 billion a year starting to, I mean, as of 2025, we...
So starting in 2024, we're doing 35 million barrels a year.
In order to meet...
24, 25, 26, and 27. So that 140 million barrels, plus the 60 million barrels that we're planning to purchase physically, would more than cover the 180 million barrels that we sold this year.
I hope that helps the committee a little bit get an idea of where we are right now, because it is alarming. And Dr. Huff, I'm out of time in consideration of my committee, but I really want to talk to you concerning our disposal of nuclear waste. And they had a Blue Ribbon Committee, and all, we want to hear about that. So if I get a second round, if one of my colleagues here does not ask that question, I'd like to get into that with you. And with that, I'll turn to Senator Barrasso.
Yeah, thank you.